All right. Hi, and welcome to Dave's Life Over 65. This is part two. Oh, B just landed on my camera. Easily distracted. Dave's Life Over 65. This is part two. I'm actually going to start to try to make a fire out of basically what I had on me and stuff I found in the that was relatively dry. So hope you enjoy. Okay, this is my little Swiss Army knife. I don't know if it's sharp enough to do what I need it to do, but we'll try. My knockoff of the Swiss Army knife. You could do it, but it really takes a lot of effort. So you know what? This is going to get sharpened if I remember to do so tonight. And out comes my other everyday carry, which is always in my pocket. That click is why it's illegal in this stupid country. This is the worst feather stick you'll ever see. I've done this exactly one time, and you're looking at it right now. Staying attached. I guess that's something you learn as you go. Okay. Oh, a little bit of a wind has just picked up. This is when I want to start a fire. Alright, let's see if by some miracle you can actually start a fire with a fire. If there is some
This is not going to happen.
Almost broke one of the main rules of starting a fire, and that is to not have your kindling ready and your tinder. Good old birch bark. Good old birch bark. Now what we need to do ASAP. What we need to do right now is put some of these bigger pieces across like this. Take the smaller pieces. yeah, golden rule, I forgot. Make sure you give it oxygen.
Boys and girls.
Okay, what are our conclusions here? Well, when the weather is damp and the ground is covered with dew and everything's been rained on, the best thing to do is find lots and lots and lots of birch bark. Okay, I don't really intend to make a good fire right now. But this is stuff picked up right off the ground. Sounds dry, but it's not. Holding the wet stuff up off the fire to try to dry it out. Obviously, if I was going to be doing this for a campfire to cook or boil water, there would be a hell of a lot more wood in there. And I would try to make it drier, if possible. I miss my little human bellows. Yep. Okay, so for this occasion, this is basically just very small kindling. Well, I consider that a success. What I would do next is pile larger pieces, larger dry pieces. But I'm gonna let this burn down because you don't really want to have a fire for too long today. Part of the trick is making sure that you allow enough oxygen to get through it. Thank you. Now that little fire there would be enough to maybe boil a cup of water, make a tea, coffee, or cook something. A cup of soup. Maybe any kind of stuff.